In the fall of 1818, several Indian tribes give up their claim to a very large area of central Indiana. From this area, the Miami Indians reserve a large tract as their homeland. This reservation includes all the lands that now make up Howard County. In 1837, a section called 7 Mile Strip is bought from the Miami Indians by the U.S. government and transferred to the Indiana government. David Landrum, a Quaker from Tennessee, builds the first house in 7 Mile Strip. In 1844, David Foster, a local trader, donates 40 acres of land on which to found the new county seat. As the area's first philanthropist, he assumes naming rights and calls the town Kokomo, after an exceptionally tall Miami Indian. In 1850, the first census of Howard County shows a population of 1,857. Until 1886, Howard County is strictly an agricultural region. Then, something big happens. October 6, 1886, natural gas is discovered in north central Indiana. Very quickly, Kokomo becomes an industrial center. 1887, Kokomo Straw Board begins operations. Also in 1887, diamond plate glass begins operations. 1888, Kokomo opalescent glass begins operations. By 1893, Kokomo's population has soared to 15,000. On July 4, 1894, inventor Elwood Haynes skips the Independence Day picnic and instead road tests his first car on Pumpkin Vine Pike east of Kokomo. Elwood drives, Elmer Apperson is his passenger. They roar down the road at 7 miles per hour. The test is a success, and thus is born the first commercially built automobile. This is the beginning of a flood of firsts coming from Kokomo. 1894, first pneumatic rubber tire. 1895, first aluminum casting. 1902, first carburetor. 1906, first stellite cobalt-based alloy. 1912, first stainless steel. 1918, first American howitzer shell used in warfare. Also in 1918, first aerial bomb with fins. 1920, first mechanical corn picker. 1926, first Duralite golden-hued tableware. 1928, first canned tomato juice. 1938, first push-button car radio. 1941, first all-metal lifeboat. 1943, first all-metal life raft. 1947, first signal-seeking car radio. 1957, first all-transistor car radio. Kokomo takes pride in its innovative spirit and calls itself the City of Firsts. Kokomo continues to grow and prosper through the second half of the 20th century, thanks primarily to manufacturing, especially for the automotive industry. By the year 2000, the population is 45,468. As the 21st century dawns, Kokomo's prosperity and reputation are starting to slip. We are seen around the state as a city in decline. The comments are not very flattering. Kokomo lacks the education to succeed in today's economy. Kokomo is too dependent on automotive manufacturing. Kokomo needs to diversify. Kokomo's workforce doesn't have the skills for today's jobs. In 2008, things look very dark. Forbes magazine names Kokomo the third fastest dying town in America. And then, things get worse. Chrysler, Delphi, GM, and Haynes all file for restructuring. The city's budget is strained to the breaking point. Unemployment soars from 7.4% to 19.2%. Home foreclosures average more than 67 per month. Not surprisingly, many people are ready to write off Kokomo as a city whose time has come and gone. Those people didn't know us. They didn't know this city is built on innovation and entrepreneurial drive. Kokomo is a city strengthened by adversity. Kokomo is a city filled with hardworking people who will come together to face monumental challenges. In order for Kokomo to thrive, public officials partner with private industry, higher education, and economic development organizations. The result? An astonishing U-turn. Today, municipal government is more efficient, cost-effective, and responsive. Wages and benefits have decreased from 71% to 61% of the city budget. Investments in capital improvements have risen from 3% to 5%. We merged multiple separate entities into one strong, powerful economic development alliance. We've gone around the corner and around the world to build relationships that are resulting in new economic development. We're assisting existing businesses and attracting new businesses, utilizing a variety of programs. We're demonstrating new ways to collaborate with public and private partners. Old and new friends alike are investing in Kokomo. The results? 3,832 jobs retained, 2,476 jobs added. Local unemployment has been cut from nearly 20% to just over 10%. Public and private partnerships are also improving quality of life in Kokomo. Investments in infrastructure and beautification make our downtown more attractive to businesses and visitors alike. We're on the move. We're looking good. Today, Kokomo is a great place for businesses to locate, grow, and expand. For residents to live, work, and raise families. For tourists to visit. For all to see what recovery looks like. How did this happen? We made a U-turn because of a U-turn. U-turn challenges into opportunities. U-turned down for the count into count me in. U-turned Kokomo into the Indiana Chamber 2011 Community of the Year. Congratulations, Kokomo. This is what we accomplished together.